Hello friends, welcome to Dial Android YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to restore your warranty on Samsung Galaxy S3 after rooting your phone or installing a custom ROM. This video will help you to install official updates OT over the ear or using keys after doing this procedure. So first, let me show you how Samsung determines how that your warranty is being void or you have installed any custom ROM or rooted your phone. So first thing is obviously the interface. You can see whether it's a custom ROM or you have the super user application. And the other thing is they can check the device status. For that you need to go to the about device and go to the status, and you will see this thing is as a modified. And also you will not be able to get the over the air update. It will show this warning that your device has been modified, so software updates are not available. So to solve this, you need to first have few things which I have mentioned in the blog, like you need to have a rooted phone with triangle away application, and you need to download a stock firmware from sammobile.com. So all those things and link, the corresponding links are available in the blog. Just go ahead and install everything first and then go ahead with the procedure. So first I'll show you one more thing here. They have one more thing like flash counter or the binary status in the download menu to determine whether your warranty is being void or not. So let me show you that also. It will show up once you reboot your phone into download mode. There you go, and you can see here that it is shown as custom and flash counter yes. That means that you have downloaded a custom binary and your warranty is void. So to solve that, we need to do a few things. I'll tell you, first phase will be we need to do this counter reset using triangle away application. Second thing we will do, we install a stock firmware using Odin, and then we will go ahead with a over the air update so that your device will be completely on stock and you can update your phone and your warranty will also be back. So for that you need to make sure you have installed triangle away application. There you go. Just run that application. It will ask for the rights initially. It will confirm your model number, and then just click on the reset flash counter. Click on continue, and it will reboot your phone into a special mode. There you go. So now you can see this is one and custom. Once you press the volume up key, it will reset the counter. So now this job is done. You can check it using the download menu. You can go to the download menu with volume down, home button and the power button. There you go. So you can see now the binary, custom binary download is no, the binary is official, but the system status is still custom. So for that we need to flash a stock firmware. So let me switch on my system now. You need to download a firmware which is little old so that you can check with over the air update. So you need to run the Odin software, and I will connect my phone into download mode, and the same will be shown here as added. You can see the thing added here, and now just select that file. Okay, this will be the file, and you have to put it in PDM mode, and just don't recheck the repartition or put any PIT file or something. Just click on the start. So now it will flash the firmware. You can see the progress here. It will take little time since it's a big firmware, around 800 MB, so it will take little time. Let me show you whether the process has been started or not. You can see here you have to wait little. So you can see the process has been started. You can see the cache is being, and you will see soon a slider moving on here which is showing the process. So once this process is complete, you need to reboot your phone. It will automatically reboot. In fact, you will see pass here, and the phone will be rebooted. Once it gets reboot, you need to set up your phone as normal and we'll see the process after that. So let this process complete first. So once the process is complete, you will see a pass notification here. We have skipped the video so to save your time. So now you can see the pass and the device will be booted. It will take little time for initial setup, around 3 to 5 minutes for the system to boot. So let me skip that section in the video. So once your phone is booted, it will take around 5 to 6 minutes, and if it's still not booting, you need to go to the recovery and wipe the data, and then it will be rebooted. No issues with that. After that, you will see this screen. This is the welcome screen which you see when you get the new box packing phone. Now I'll set up my Wi-Fi just to show you the over there updates. There you go. So it's connected. Now next, I'll not set up any other thing, just skip it. Okay, so now my phone is back to the stock firmware, and we have to set up the firmware update. So you can select the country for which you have downloaded the firmware, obviously. So suppose I have downloaded for India. I will register the device now. That's done. Okay, so now you need to check whether your phone is back to stock or not. So for that, we'll go to the settings again and go to the about status. It is showing already it's connecting to the server. So if the phone is back to the stock, then obviously you will see this screen. So now you can see the phone is automatically downloading the over the air updates. The same can be done by a key. So now your phone is back to the warranty, 100% on the stock. Let me show you the device status also. I hope it has came by now. No, it's still scanning. So just wait for 1 or 2 minutes more. I think it will come. By the time, you can see your that update is already getting downloaded. That itself shows that your phone is back to the stock. But still, just for check, I want to show you this also. So in this way, if your phone is having some problem or something, you can just go back to your stock before going to the service center. Or if you are waiting for official Jelly Bean update, then this might help you, because you can directly update using keys or your over there firmware update. Still scanning. Okay, I'll do this later. Okay, maybe 30 minutes later. I'm just waiting for this device status. So in this process, if you face any issues, just comment here on YouTube or on the blog. We'll definitely going to help you. It takes around 2-3 minutes time to get that system status, device status. And make sure you don't have any file related with super user or chain fire thing on your phone, because it may prove that you have rooted your phone or something. So it's better to avoid those things. Format your phone completely and now your phone should be new. It is taking huge time. Okay, please come fast. And as I suggested in the blog, try to download the firmware which is little old, so that you can instantly get the OT updates. Oh, still scanning. I can show you the same in the download menu. Just wait for 5-10 seconds more, otherwise I'll show. Yeah, so you can see the device status is now normal. So your phone is 100% on warranty now. Enjoy the Samsung warranty. And thanks for watching, guys. If you have any questions, just post in the comments and we'll help you. Thanks.